Good evening and welcome to ABC24. I'm Kevin McNamara. First off, tonight we are just finding out that in a letter, the Tennessee Board of Judicial Conduct has recommended Shelby County Judge Melissa Boyd be removed from office. This according to the Daily Memphian. Boyd is a recently indicted judge from Shelby County who admitted to using cocaine while on the job. Last month, Boyd was also charged with coercing and harassing her campaign manager. Boyd has been suspended from that role since May of 2023 and has had two public reprimands. Now, the letter, signed by Lieutenant Governor Randy McNally and Speaker Cameron Sexton, are recommending her removal from office. Her current term ends in August of 2030. And the trial dates have all been scheduled in the death of Tyre Nichols. A civil lawsuit filed by Nichols' mother against the city for his death now has a date set for a jury trial in 2025. The $550 million lawsuit blames Memphis police for his death and accuses MPD Interim Chief C.J. Davis of turning a blind eye on the aggressive policing of the Scorpion Unit. The federal trial is set for May of this year, the state trial for August, and the civil trial will be conducted next January. And in case you missed it, Shelby County District Attorney Steve Mulroy wants to fast-track some trials. Our Leah Williams has the latest.
DA Steve Mulroy identified 11 violent criminal offenses, things like murder, smash and grabs, and carjackings that he believed needed to go to trial sooner. Mulroy plans to make this happen by focusing on three categories: bail, trial speed, and staying on top of investigations.
Shelby County DA Steve Mulroy is emphasizing all bail hearings need to consider public safety. He says prosecutors will be doing more extensive checks on criminal history before requesting bail and pushing to revoke bail for defendants if they have any other run-ins with the law before the trial.
Different judicial commissioners are more or less willing to consider public safety as a factor in the bail determination. We believe public safety is always a relevant consideration.
Prosecutors also have to meet a number of internal deadlines. This includes getting through general sessions within 60 days, indictments within 30 days, and getting through the entire trial or reaching a plea deal within 15 months.
If a prosecutor, you know, has a case that doesn't meet those deadlines, they just are going to have to explain why.
When it comes to investigations, the DA wants prosecutors to make extra efforts to monitor jail calls and stay in contact with law enforcement. Josh Spickler with the restorative justice organization Just City says the initiative is a good step, but believes revoking bail is a big flaw in the plan.
Jail is not for punishment. Jail is to make sure someone gets to court and to protect the community. We're using the jail for punishment. But the fact that the DA stepped up and said, our office is committed, is a big first step.
DA Mulroy and those with Just City emphasize that prosecutors can only do so much and that judges also play a major role in the speed of trials. DA Mulroy said if each judge took on just two trials a month, Shelby County could return to the pre-pandemic number of 200 cases a year. Back to you.
Switching to weather now, we have meteorologist Corey Smith here. Corey, how's our forecast looking now that we're seemingly finally through some of the bad weather here?
Yeah, we've been getting that rain today. Mm-hmm. This is the last rain. We've had that snow, the freeze, the rain to start off 2024.
We've been through it all. I feel like we've been through the ringer. Proud to make it to the other
side. Except for the sunshine, which is finally returning back in the forecast. So we'll talk about it here in a second. Let's take a look at radar. You can see some of this rain that's pivoting through right now. This is an area of low pressure working through the Mid-South and currently still seeing most of that precipitation north of I-4 in the viewing area right now. This should last for a couple more hours, and then we are in the clear as far as rain goes. So it's your Sunday looking pretty good. At least it should be dry. Temperatures currently in the low to mid 40s, so definitely a cooler afternoon. And as we head into the overnight, temperatures not falling too much. It'll be close to 40 as you're getting up tomorrow morning. So maybe heading out tonight, it is going to be at least the chance of some showers around 7 p.m., but we do start to dry out with temperatures still close to where they are right now. Tomorrow morning, waking up close to 40 degrees, but plenty of cloud cover tomorrow. That's going to be really the big thing, is just a gloomy day once again, but we are going to at least see that rainfall out of the area. You'll see that here as we move things forward in your forecast model, that temperatures are not moving too much tonight, and that's going to be the case really throughout tomorrow as well. I expect this to be in the low to mid 40s in the afternoon. So definitely a chilly day, a gloomy day, but that is setting the stage for much nicer weather as we go into next week. So tomorrow afternoon, 43 degrees right around 2 p.m. as well as 4 p.m. You can see overcast conditions, but I would still try to get outside. At least it's going to be dry. We're not dealing with any shower chances. Here's that area of low pressure moving through right now. That's going to be replaced by high pressure as we go into your Monday, and we're eventually going to see that sunshine building in and mild temperatures as we go into next week. We'll be watching an upper level low move in over the eastern part of the state that could increase our clouds on Wednesday, but not expecting any precipitation chances with that. And we'll eventually start to see some cloud cover returning towards Thursday and Friday of next week. So your 7-day forecast going forward, what we can expect: low of 40 degrees tonight, up to 45 in the afternoon with mostly cloudy skies. As you go into your Monday, completely sunny conditions. It's going to be a nice change from what we've been seeing. A low of 33, so definitely a cooler start to the day, up to 52 in the afternoon, then more mild as you go into your Tuesday with a high of 61 degrees. As you go into Wednesday, you get a little bit of a reinforcing shot of cooler with that upper level low, so temperature is a little bit cooler, back down to 50 degrees, close to freezing on your Thursday morning. And then past that, we just stay quiet. You can see we do have some clouds increasing as you go into your next Friday with a high of 58, but overall we're going to be on the mild side. Temperature is likely above average, not only this week, but potentially into the very beginning of February as well.
Corey, thank you. Shelby County having high crime rates is no secret, but a newly announced proposal hopes to make the streets here in Shelby County safer by changing the state's bail system. Right now, the Tennessee State Constitution says all crimes come with mandatory bail, with the exception of capital murder. But this proposal could change that.
This is actually community-led. I mean, I'm hearing from constituents that are concerned about the crime wave, the crime crisis.
Numerous Mid-South officials on both sides of the aisle presenting a united front on Friday, proposing a constitutional amendment that would give judges more freedom to hold accused criminals without bail. Memphis Mayor Paul Young believes giving more power to judges in Shelby County can help tamp down crime in the Bluff City.
I think it's important to ensure that the judges have the ability to have discretion when you have instances of individuals that have perpetrated many violent offenses in our community. And so I don't want to be the one that's stipulating all the parameters to make it happen.
Despite the big announcement, the potential move would be several years away. As a constitutional amendment, it needs to pass through both the Tennessee House and Senate this year, then again during a new assembly in 2026.
You saw Democrats and Republicans, you saw progressives and conservatives, you saw black and white, you saw city and county. The crime is a significant issue in Memphis, and we have to solve this crime problem.
After that, Memphians will get their chance to make their voices heard. It would go on the ballot to the voters alongside the governor's race in 2026 and would need to get more votes than whoever takes office that fall.
In other news, check this out. Expectant mothers in Memphis will now have easier access to birthing options with the city's first full-service doula-only center opening today. Chenille Bowens will move from her home office to her first brick-and-mortar center for naturally nurtured birth services. This new space has a community closet filled with everything a baby needs: lactation rooms, yoga and massage studios, and an education space to learn all about the birth process. Shelby County has one of the highest maternal mortality rates in Tennessee. Reports show that women with a doula are more likely to have healthier birthing outcomes. Naturally Nurtured Birth Services serves about 400 clients on Medicaid. The grand opening was today, and our team is there right now. So if you could not attend, check back with us at 10 p.m. with the latest details. And in state news across Tennessee, the state of Tennessee needs more than $68 billion worth of public infrastructure, $35 billion of which is just for transportation. That's according to a new state report looking at the needs from July 21 to June 2026. The report also says transportation needs increased for the seventh year in a row. There was a $1.1 billion increase in costs for existing road projects and $405 million increase for new road projects, although that was offset by $752 million in completed road projects. And some lawmakers in Tennessee are pushing to eliminate the statewide grocery tax. Right now, Tennessee has a 4% sales tax on food and is one of just 13 states that still taxes groceries. In recent years, the state has had grocery tax holidays, but this would be permanent. Last year, Tennessee's three-month-long tax holiday cost the state more than $270 million. But now Democrats in the House and Senate argue the tax should be eliminated altogether, arguing it's a regressive tax and affects the state's poorest families. According to SoFi, the average Tennessean spends just over $3,000 on groceries each year. If the grocery tax was eliminated entirely, shoppers would save $120 a year. Hey, that's quite the deal, huh?
Oh, yeah, not too bad. And now that the grocery stores are finally stocked back up,
I'm excited. Anything that helps it less on my wallet when I'm getting groceries. It's time to send you back to the game. Make sure you stay up late. After all, the sports are over. We'll be right here for you after the game.